Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I'll show you how easy it is to bind local and remote data to an Angular spreadsheet component. I will also show you how to bind data to the individual cells in a sheet and change the data source dynamically with a button click. First, I open my existing project, where I have installed the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular spreadsheet package, and all the necessary spreadsheet modules are configured in the app module file. In the app component HTML file, the basic spreadsheet rendering code is added here. In the app component file, I have assigned a data source object, order details, to the variable data. This data variable is assigned to the data source property. Notice that the data.js file has local JSON data, and it has the fields customer name, model, color, payment mode, delivery date, and amount. You can refer to our Angular spreadsheet getting started video to learn more about local JSON data binding, the link for which I've shared in the card above and the description below. Let me run this example and show you the initial output. You can see that the spreadsheet rendered with the specified JSON data. I can also bind remote service to the spreadsheet. To bind remote data, I need to access the online data service with the help of the Data Manager. The Data Manager is a Syncfusion component that acts as a gateway and interacts with both local and remote data sources. In this example, I'm going to use the Web API adapter to bind data. I open app component TS file and import the Data Manager and Web API adapter from the Syncfusion EJ2 data package. To the data variable, replace this local data object with the Data Manager instance. To interact with a remote data service, the Data Manager requires the following minimum configuration, URL, and adapter. I provide a valid service URL here. This is the online service, which I'm going to use in my application. Then I need to specify the adapter type. The adapter is responsible for processing the response from the service endpoint and the request to it. Set the adapter with the Web API adapter, as the service URL passed to the Data Manager is based on the Web API standards. Then enable the cross-domain property. Looking here, the spreadsheet is rendered with the remote data. Next, I will show you how to bind data to an individual cell in the spreadsheet. I comment out the eRanges tag. Then add a eRows tag to specify a collection of row details. Using the eRow tag, I can specify details for a single row. Then I include the eCells tag to specify a collection of cell details. Using the eCell tag, I can specify data for individual cells. I'll keep this row as the header. Using the value property, I provide the header, category 4, column 1. In the same way, I provide headers for the other columns, planned cost, actual cost, and difference. Again, I add the row tag to specify details for the first row below header. Here, I provide the cell values for this row. For the last cell, I include formula property to display the difference between planned and actual cost. In the same way, I add the cell details for the other rows. Checking now, the provided cell data is displayed in the spreadsheet. This column calculates the difference between the planned and actual cost using a formula. I can also set styles and format a cell. I open app component TS file and declare the constant variable bold center. And define the CSS styles font weight to bold and text align to center. I assign this object to the header cells using the style property. Copy and paste this property to all the header cells. Let's see how to apply format to these three columns. I open app component TS file. I declare another variable, currency format, of string type. Use the method getFormat from type, and provide the format name currency as an argument. Here, I import the getFormat from type from Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Spreadsheet package. I assign this variable to the format property in the required cells. Copy and paste this property in the required cells. See now, specified styles are applied to the header cells. And currency format is applied to other columns. I can also change the sheet name using the name property. To do that, I assign the value monthly budget. Notice the sheet name is changed to monthly budget. Finally, I will show you how to change the data source dynamically with an external button click. Here I'm going to bind remote data and on button click reload the spreadsheet with local data source. First, I uncomment the ranges tag to render the remote data and comment out the rows tag to unbound the cell data. To demonstrate this, I add the button tag and set the content change data. To apply Syncfusion button CSS styles to this button, I add class name eButton. Also, set the inline CSS style, margin 5 pixels, to align this button inside the wrapper. I add a click event and assign the callback method button click. I open app component TS file. I define this callback method here. Inside this method, I assign the local data source order details to the variable data. I also change the data type from DataManager to object since I'm loading the local JSON object. Checking now, when I click the button, the data source has changed. In this video, I have shown you how to bind local and remote data to the Syncfusion Angular Spreadsheet component. I also showed you how to bind cell data and change the data source dynamically. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our Angular products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.